Okay, hello YouTube, and Lux Royale is back from my parents, and now many of you who has watched my videos are thinking that what they did again. Now actually my parents are very careful with the vacuums. It's not about that. Very shortly I explain what has happened with my parents' vacuums. So they had my Philips Performer Pro and the power switch broke. But then I had to bypass the circuit board, and now it can be only used with 16 amp fuse. What means that my dad said when I offered that to him that no, that's too difficult. We have to take the electricity from the bathroom, and I totally understand. Okay? Then I gave my Volta F1, and motor broke and it was going bad, and that was my fault. So then I was in the situation where I was thinking that what I give to them, and I just gave this, and I really didn't think that this is very heavy and big. They used this 5 months, about that, 4 months about, and I asked how is the vacuum, and it was like, okay, it is okay, nothing wrong with it. And yesterday I went with new bags, and that was too much for them. My mom is over 60 years old, and she said, okay, now I have to say that it is way too big and clumsy vacuum. It is good, Saxon is good, and like it is very good in this Saxon and iPhone. So, well, okay, then I realized that yes, that is the case, and they didn't want to tell me because they knew how much I liked this vacuum. So, okay, what they have now is my Sipo K1 canister, and from these pictures you can see how much smaller that Sipo is compared to this Lux Royal. So it is much smaller, and it doesn't have hose coming from the front, and it is full caster wheels, so perfect for older people. And they have now my pneumatic turbo brush with it, and then combination nozzle and adapter to fit that Sipo. And I explained everything. My dad just picked that Sipo today, and yes. So I have not touched this, and we have to see how the back compartment looks like, because there is that pneumatic HEPA flow bag. So let's open this bad boy, and yes. Okay, there is stuff. And yes, I have to put a lot of tape there to make sure that this doesn't leak. Okay, let's move this a bit. So okay, there is a lot. So I will put new bag
to this.
And before we put new bag, this to it, I want to make sure that the bag compartment is free of any dust leakages, and I am not sure, can I? Yes, flash is now on, so can you see that tiny bit? There is that mess screen, and why it is there is because that HEPA flow bag got sucked in there, and now there is good amount of space those bags to breathe, and I am always very careful when I give some vacuum to others that it really works what it has. So tiny bit of dust there. And otherwise it looks clean. So flash off, so I don't drain the battery, and my phone is getting hot if I am just using that flash. So okay, now one important thing what I should mention is that there is that safety switch, but I had to lock because it is meant for preventing use this vacuum without the bag, original bag, but is cardboard to this level, and when it knows that there is bag, then it lets the vacuum run. But because now I use this, this would not turn on. This looks royal. So let's put this, and this is tight fit. This is something what I am always very critical about, that these don't leak. These bag fittings, and it was very tight. And I also use these same bags with my Kirby Tradition. And this is a bit trickier than normal, using the normal looks bags. So there it is, and overall in good condition. They have not really done any damage to this. One thing what you have to be careful with these old vacuums with these electronic power controls is that if you plug that to the same outlet where you have computer and so on, it somehow can confuse the circuit board, and that power goes up and down and just without touching the vacuum. So okay, enough of rambling. Now let's put the hose back to it, and now this is going to be something a bit different. So straight suction vacuuming, and let's put that to side. How much we can get with straight suction vacuuming? So we are going to use this bag saver plus this one of my favorite nozzles. My parents didn't have this, but this is automatic floor head, combination floor head. You have seen this And if you want to know more about this, ask me where that video is. So how we connect that? We have to put this, if you can see that. Yes. Oh man, that is loose. So I have to pause and put a bit tape to this, because this is not meant for this. Okay, so a bit tape, so it can hold, I hope. Let's put this to the lowest position. This is empty. And how this looks, royal sounds, because, and very long cable, 9 meters this cable, if I remember right. Now, that back saver makes that cyclonic noise quite a lot. Oh my lids. Okay. And I have not turned this on. So it is on max, so yes, I knew that they would use that. So how does it sound? Fantastic. Now this has more airflow on the minimum power than most bagless vacuums, so yes. Now let's position everything and start that manual labor what these stretch suction nozzles need. Okay, now let's see if this bag saver, what is plastic, can take the stress, because there is going to be that manual rubbing. What you have to do without the power hair, and yes, I have power hair cable for this, so don't worry about that. There is videos coming with the power hair also. But with power hack. But that's another story, so let's start. Thank you. Okay, let's see a bit closer what we picked up, and overall ending for this video and how it went. Okay, so looks did well with the surface cleaning, but obviously carpet looks like clean, it's not deep down clean like with the overhead, even Turbo Plus does better job, but oh man, this static is crazy because of this plastic and dirt spinning there that makes that static electricity. Let's take this off. And this is about 99% efficient, this cyclonic bag saver. Let's take things to the bottom and open it. And what if we put this? Sorry, looks. Well, okay. And yes, let's put this back this way. Like that. So there is everything what it picked up and that's not bad. I mean, we use just this. And this is one of the best straight suction nozzles because this glides very easily over the rug and carpet. And it is heavy and bulky because this automatic floating thing what I lock it now. But this is very nice here. But yes, there is everything what it picked up. And yes. Looks is back. Real looks. Not those Eureka Electroluxes. If you know what I mean. This is truly looks product and totally different factory design and everything compared to the Eureka looks like some cool. But anyway, yes, this is home video, so thank you for watching and goodbye.